Hey everyone, this is Bhargav Sathar, and today we will learn a very important topic, equivalence relation. Now in this session we will just learn what is an equivalence relation and some of the examples of the equivalence relation. Now first understand what is an equivalence relation. Now we know that what is a relation, it is a subset of Cartesian product. Now to be precise, what is an equivalence relation? Let capital R be a relation in a set capital A. So that means it is a relation. So R, it is a subset of, here we have only one set. So that means both the sets are same. So R is a subset of A cross A by the definition of relation. Okay. Then R is said to be an equivalence relation on A, if and only if these three conditions or three axioms hold. The first one, capital R is a reflexive relation. Now in previous session we discussed all the types of relation. So yes, you are right. What is a reflexive relation? That is, for every A in A, A is related to itself. That means A is related to A, or AA belongs to the relation. The second one, capital R is a symmetric relation. And what is a symmetric relation? If AB belongs to R, that means, that implies BA belongs to R. Or in short, if A is related to B, then B has to be related to A. And the third one, R has to be a transitive relation. And what is a transitive relation? If AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, that implies A and C belongs to R. And in short, if A is related to B, B is related to C, then A has to be related to C. Okay, so for equivalence relation, if a relation is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, then it is called an equivalence relation. Now, the diagram of an equivalence relation will be like this. How? See, we have 3 points, so A, B, C. Now, this loop indicates that they are reflexive. So that means B is related to B, A is related to A, and C is related to C. Next, for symmetric, like this. A, if A is related to B, then B is related to A. If A is related to C, then C is related to A. If B is related to C, then C is related to B. That's it. Now, by using this, the transitivity will be applicable. Like this, if A is related to B, B is related to C, then A is related to C. So in this manner, you can check all the six possibilities. So this will be the diagram of an equivalence relation. Let us discuss example. The question is, let capital I be the set of all integers. Let the relation R be defined over the set I by A is related to B if and only if. The relation is given like this. A minus B is an even integer, where A and B both belongs to I. I is set of all integers. Now show that R is an equivalence relation. Now to prove or to check whether a relation is an equivalence relation, we need to just check all three axioms. That means it has to be a reflexive relation, it has to be a symmetric relation, and it has to be a transitive relation. So for first, let us check whether it is reflexive or not. So since, see, the condition is A minus B is an even integer. So for reflexive, both the points are same. So since A minus A equals 0, and that is 0. Now, 0 is an even integer, that is very obvious. So that implies A is related to A for every A in the given set. So hence, R is a reflexive relation. So the first axiom holds. Now let us go to the second one. Now, if A is related to B, now for what is the condition for symmetricity? That is, if A is related to B, then B has to be related to A. So that means first, if A is related to B, then if A is related to B, then what is the condition? A minus B is an even integer. Yes, it is an even integer. Now, by this, we can also say that if A minus B is an even integer, that means B minus A is also an even integer, but obviously it will be an even integer. So that means B is related to A. So that's it, it's proved. If A is related to B, then B is related to A. Hence, R is a symmetric relation. Third, for transitivity. For transitivity, we need to check if A is related to B and B is related to C, then has to be related to C. So the first, A is related to B and B is related to C. If A is related to B, then A minus B is an even integer by the definition. If B is related to C, that means B minus C is an even integer. Now, whenever if we combine or if we add both this, so that means A minus B plus B minus C, that will also be an even integer because if we add two even integers, so the resultant will also be an even integer. So A minus B plus B minus C, but that is A minus C, so it will be an even integer. But A minus C is an even integer, that means A is related to C. So we are through. So hence, R is transitive relation. So since R is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, so it will be an equivalence relation. Next example, let capital X is given, the points are 1 to 7, and the relation is given like this. Set of all xy such that x minus y is divisible by 3. And the question is, show that R is an equivalence relation and draw graph of R. Now the relation is given x minus y is divisible by 3. Now this is the given data, x is from 1 to 7 and R is set of all xy such that x minus y is divisible by 3. Now this can be represented or rewritten as R equals to set of all xy such that, see here x minus y is divisible by 3. So that means x minus y can be represented as like this, x minus y equals to 3 times k and k belongs to set of integers. So this means that x minus y is multiple of 3. So the meaning are same, x minus y is divisible by 3. So that means we can represent x minus y such that it is a multiple of 3. So x minus y equals to 3 times k, where k belongs to set of integers. Now we will check whether it is an equivalence relation or not. So here, x is related to itself or x is related to x. For every x belongs to x. How? Because whenever we calculate x minus x, that is 0, and 0 is always divisible by any non-zero finite number. So it is divisible by 3 also. So hence, x minus x, that can be represented as 3 into k. But to be specifically here, k equals to 0, and that is belongs to integer. So hence, x is related to x, so it is a reflexive relation. So it is done. Now, second, what is the symmetric relation? Now, for symmetric relation, if x is related to y, then y has to be related to x. So first, let us take x is related to y. Now, if x is related to y, then by definition, x minus y is divisible by 3 by definition of a given relation. So x minus y is divisible by 3. Now, this means that x minus y is multiple of 3, so which is returned as x minus y equals to 3 times k, and k belongs to z. Okay, next. So this means that now just multiply it by minus sign. So x minus y is y minus x equals to 3 times k will become minus k, and minus k also belongs to z, and that means y is related to x. So hence, R is a symmetric relation. Now, next, for transitivity, if x is related to y, y is related to z, then x has to be related to z. So, first, for that, just take it as x is related to y and y is related to z. Now, if x is related to y, then by definition of a relation, x minus y is divisible by 3, and y is related to z, so that means by the definition of a relation, y minus z is divisible by 3. Okay, now x minus y is divisible by 3, so that means x minus y, it is a multiple of 3, so it can be represented as x minus y equals to 3 times some k1, where k1 belongs to integer. In same manner, y minus z is divisible by 3, so that means y minus z is a multiple of 3, so it can be represented same as y minus z equals to 3 times some k2, some constant, and that constant belongs to z. Now, just add both these equations. So what we'll get, x minus y plus y minus z, so the left hand side, so it will become x minus z, and that is equals to 3k1 plus 3k2, so 3 is common, so 3 times k1 plus k2, where k1 and k2 belongs to z. Now, just take this integer as some k, so x minus z equals to 3k, where k is k1 plus k2 for simplicity. So, and this means that x minus z is a multiple of 3, and that means x minus z is divisible by 3, so hence x is related to z. So hence, R is a transitive relation. Since R is a reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, so it is an equivalence relation. Now in question, it is also asked that draw the graph of R. So for that, just we are rewriting the relation and the given set. So R equals to set of all xy, such that x minus y is divisible by 3, and this is 1 to 7. Now the graph of the given relation, C. For the graph of the relation, we need to write the relation, but it will contain so many elements. I'm just understanding it directly. So this will be the graph. How? See, there are total 7 points. So just one by one, just take. This loop indicates the reflexivity. So that means 1 is related to 1. Why? Because 1 minus 1, that is 0, that is also divisible by 3. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. These 7 loops will be from reflexive. Now for second one, just take 1. Now 1 minus 2, is it divisible by 3? No, it is not. So same way, 1 minus 3, is it divisible by 3? No. Now 1 minus 4, is it divisible by 3? Yes, because 1 minus 4 is minus 3, and that is divisible by 4. So that means in the relation, 1, 4 pair will be there. So here, 1, 4 pair is there, so that is 1 to 4, so this arrow. Now in same way, 4, 1 also will be there, because 4 minus 1, that is 3, and that is divides by 3. So here, in between 1 and 4, two edges will be there from different direction. So 1, 4 is there. Now in same way, 1, 5, is it divisible by 3? No. 1, 6, no. And 1, 7. So 1 and 7, they are divisible by 3. Their subtraction is divisible by 3. So in between 1 and 7. So 1, 7 and 7, 1. So this graph is done. Now just take 2. Now 2 minus 3, is it divisible by 3? No. 2, 4, no. 2, 5, yes. So 2 and 5 will be combined. So 2, 5 and same way, 5, 2 will be there. So this graph, these loops are from reflexivity and 2, 5 and 5, 2. So they are divisible by 3, their subtraction. Now just take 3. 3 and 4, their subtraction is divisible by 3, no. For 3, 5, no. For 3, 6, yes. So 3 minus 6, that is minus 3, and that is divisible by 3. So this graph will be there. So 3 and 6. And same way, 6, 3 will be there. So these are two edges. Now 4, 5, no. 4, 6, no. 4, 7, that we have already calculated. So it is done. Now 5, 6, no. And 6, 7, no. So that's it. This will be the digraph of the given relation. However, they are not connected, but it is a digraph. Now, just I'm giving you example. You just try it yourself. Show that the congruent modulo n is an equivalence relation. And in symbolic form, it will be like this. A is congruent to B mod n. Then it is an equivalence relation. You need to check. So you need to check the reflexivity, transitivity, and symmetricity. Now I'm just giving you one hint that see, A is congruent to B mod n if and only if we can write like this. N divides this n, modulus of n divides the subtraction. N divides A minus B. Now you just use this and it will be very easy. Just the previous sum. Thank you.